Good afternoon, students. Today we shall discuss about Mach circuit, that is multi-stage impulse generators. I have said already that generator's capacitance C1 is to be first charged and then discharged into the wave shaping circuits. A single capacitor C1 may be used for voltages up to 200 kV. Why we require multi-stage impulse generators means because a single capacitor may be used for voltage up to 200 kV, and single capacitor and its charging unit may be costly and the size becomes very large. That's why they will go for the multi-stage impulse generator, that is Mach circuit. Okay. For producing very high voltages, a bank of capacitors are charged in parallel and then discharged in series. This is the diagram for that Mach circuit. Capacitance of the generators are C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. What about charging resistors are R1, R2, R3, R4, R5. Spark gaps, you can see here, spark gap is S1, S2, S3, S4. Okay. See, we will take capacitance C1, C2. How we will choose that? We will, C is chosen such that the product CRS, that is RS is a resistance R1, R2. Or you can take as R2 dash R, this one, okay, R2 dash, R3 dash, R4 dash and R5 dash. CRS is about 10 seconds to 1 minute. Next, when the impulse generator is to be discharged, the gap GR made to spark over simultaneously by some external means. The capacitor C gets connected in series and discharged into the load capacitance. The circuit employing the principle of charging the capacitor in parallel and discharging them in series known as Mach circuit. This is used to generate the high voltage impulse wave. In this method of obtaining surge voltage, the number of capacitors C1, C2, C3, C4 are connected in parallel are charged from HT transformer through a rectifying device is indicated in the circuit. At a certain voltage, which depends upon the setting of the trigger gaps. Okay, a certain voltage which depends upon the setting of trigger gaps. The trigger gaps breakdown connects the capacitor in series. Thus, voltage applied to the test specimen becomes equal to the sum of voltage to which each of the capacitor is charged. They are saying that voltage applied to the test specimen becomes equal to the sum of voltage to which each of the capacitor is charged. The trigger gaps are set in such a way that S1 breaks down at a voltage slightly lower than S2, and the trigger gap S2 breaks down at a voltage slightly lower than S3, and it will continue. Okay, it means the trigger gap S1 breaks down first and then S2, S3, S4, etc. one by one. Okay, any number of trigger gaps, okay, usually up to 50 if you take, can be used to obtain suitable voltage impulse. Next, problems on this. First problem is they have given 12 stage impulse generator and capacitance they have given 0.126 microfarad. The wave front and wave tail resistance connected are, they have given that RT and RF. Okay, they have given that R1, R2, 800 and 500. Sorry, 5000 respectively. If the load capacitance is 1000 picofarad, find the front and tell times of the impulse wave produced. They have asked t, okay, t1, t2, we need to find out. What about c1? c1 is equal to c divided by n. There is a formula, c1 is equal to c divided by n, okay. N value is 12 and C value is 0.126, you will get C1 is equal to 0.0105 microfarad. T1 is equal to, formula is there for T1 is equal to V into R open bracket C1 into C2 divided by C1 plus C2 close bracket. If we substitute the value of C1 and C2, C1 value is 0.0105 into C2 value is 0.001. Okay, and they have taken microfarad. Okay. Next, you substitute the C1, C2 value, and next we got C1 value. Okay. What about C2 value? C2 value is 1000 picofarad. So substitute, you'll get T1 is equal to 2.193. microseconds. Okay, what about time to tell? T2 is equal to 0.7 R1 plus R2 C1 plus C2. We know the value of C1 is 0.0105 and C2 value is 1000 picofarad. If we convert into microfarad, you'll get 0.001. okay, that is what we have substituted here. Okay, convert picofarad into microfarad. Okay, convert first, next you substitute. Okay, T2 you'll get 46.69 microseconds. This is what they have asked, that front and tail time, T1 and T2. Next, an impulse generator has 8 stages. That means N is equal to what? 8. With each condenser rated for 0.16 microfarad and 125 kV, the load capacitor invariable is 1000 picofarad. Find the series resistance and the damping resistance needed to produce 1.2 clash or 50 microseconds impulse wave. What is the maximum output voltage? Then first we need to find out R1, R2, and next we need to find out voltage. Okay, V maximum. We need to find out V maximum. N is equal to 8, C1 is equal to C divided by N. What is the value of C? They have given that 0.16 microfarad. So substitute 0.16 divided by 8, you will get 0.02 microfarad C1 value. What about C2? Load capacitance, they have given 1000 picofarad. Convert into microfarad, you will get 0.001 microfarad. T1 front time, they have given that 1.25. What about this? This is tail time. Okay, tail time 50 microseconds. T1 we know, they have given that 1.2 microseconds. We need to find out from this R1. We know the value of C1 and C2. Okay, substitute and get the value R1. R1 you'll get 420 ohm. Okay, substitute the values and get R1 from this equation. Okay, from this equation we can find out R1, you will get 420 ohm. Next, T2 is equal to 0.7 R1 plus R2 C1 plus C2. From this you find out R2. Okay, we know the value of R1, C1 and C2 and T2 value. Okay, only we don't know the R2. Find out R2. From this equation we get R2 value 2981 ohm. Next, DC charging voltage for 8 stages, V is equal to 8 into 120 kV. That you'll get 960 kilovolt. The maximum output voltage is, there is a formula for maximum output voltage, that is Vm is equal to V divided by R1 C2 open bracket alpha minus beta close bracket open bracket e to the power of minus alpha T1 minus e to the power of minus beta T1. Close bracket. Okay, alpha is equal to what? 1 divided by R1 C2. So we know the value of R1 and C2. Substitute, you'll get 2.3809 into 10 to the power of 6 beta value also. R2 C1, substitute, you'll get 0.01677 into 10 to the power of 6. Vm is equal to, we know the value of beta and alpha, okay? Substitute in this equation, okay? Substitute in this equation so that you'll get 891.96, that is 891.96 kV, okay? Next, calculate the front and tail resistance for 5 stage, that means N is equal to 5,000 kV with the capacitance of each stage is 5 microfarad and load capacitance is 1000 picofarad for 1 microsecond front and 50 microsecond tail. T1 is 1 microsecond, T2 is 50 microseconds. And what about C1? C1 is equal to 5 divided by 5. You will get 1 microfarad. C2 is equal to, they have given that load capacitance 1000 picofarad. Substitute the values and get R1. Okay. From equation P1, we can find out R1 because we know the values of T1, C1, C2. Okay. From this equation, we will find out R1. Okay. R1 is equal to what we get? 33.60. Next, T2 is equal to 0.7 R1 plus R2 close bracket, C1 plus C2 close bracket. This, we know the value of T2, we know the value of R1, C1 and C2 value. Okay, we don't know the value of R2. From this equation, we need to find out the R2. We get that. What we got? R2 is equal to 37.030. Next problem is, a 12-stage impulse generator has capacitors each weighted 0.3 microfarad, 150 kV. The capacitance of the test specimen T1 is equal to 3R1 C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Okay. They have given that C2 is equal to what they have given? 400 picofarad. Okay. They have given 0.3 microfarad. C value is 0.3 microfarad. And N, they have given 12 stage. So N is equal to 12. After substituting, you get 25 microfarad. C2 is equal to 400 picofarad. Substitute the values. Okay, 25 into 10 to the power of. So, C1 value, you'll get 25 nanofarad. Okay, 25 into 10 to the power of minus 9 plus 400 into 10 to the power of minus 12. After substituting, you'll get T1 is equal to 1016. Okay, 1016 ohm. Sorry. From this, they have found out R1. Okay, from this, they have found out R1. T1 is 1.2 microseconds. Sorry, okay. T1 is 1.2 microseconds. Okay. Substitute T1 and C1, C2. C1, C2. Okay, we don't know the value of R1. R1 value is 1016 ohm. T2 is equal to 0.7 R1 plus R2. We know the value of what? R1. Okay, we know the value of T2 is 50 microseconds. So substitute 50 microseconds. Here 50, okay. 50 microseconds. Next, 0.7. R1, we don't know. R2 value is 1016, C1 plus C2, okay? Sorry, R2 value is unknown, okay? R1 value is 1016, C1 value 25 nanofarad, C2 value is 400 picofarad. After substituting R2 value, you'll get 1796. Next is components of a multi-stage impulse generator. DC charging set. The charging unit should be capable of giving a variable DC voltage of either polarity to charge the generator capacitor to the required value. Charging resistors, these will be non-inductive high value. Okay, and this will be non-inductive high value of resistors of about what, 10 to 100 kilo-ohms. Each resistor will be designed to have a maximum voltage between 50 to 100 kV. Generator capacitors and spark gaps, these are arranged vertically one over the other with the all the spark gaps aligned. The capacitors are designed for several charging and discharging operations. On dead short circuit, the capacitors will be capable of giving 10 kiloamps of current. The spark gap will be usually sphere or hemisphere of 10 to 25 centimeter diameter. Sometimes it may be spherically ended by cylinder with a central support may also be used. Generator capacitors and spark gaps. You will read in detail about spark gap in experiment, okay? In high voltage lab experiments. One experiment is there on breakdown. Wave shaping resistors and capacitors. Resistors will be non-inductive wound type and should be capable of what? Resistors, it should be discharging impulse currents of 1000 amps or more. Each resistor will be designed for maximum voltage of 50 to 100 kV. What about capacitor? The load capacitors may be compressed gas or oil filled with a capacitance of 1 to 10 nanofarad. Modern generators have their wave shaping resistors included internally with flexibility to add additional resistors outside. Modern generators, how it is? Modern impulse generators, they have their wave shaping resistors included internally with the flexibility. We can add when we want extra voltage or when for extra voltage. Internally with the flexibility to add additional resistors. Okay, we can add the resistors for modern impulse generators. Why we had resistors? Why we require? It is a resistors are the capable of discharging impulse current. Okay. A commercial impulse voltage generator uses 6 set of resistors ranging from 1 to 160 ohm with the different combinations such that a resistor value varying from 0.7 to 235 ohm per stage is obtained. The resistors are usually with a voltage and energy rating of 200 to 250 kV and 2 to 5 kilowatt. The entire range of lightning and switching impulse voltage can be covered using the resistors either in series or it may be in the parallel combination. Triggering system. This consists of trigger spark gap to cause a spark gap, spark breakdown of the gaps. Voltage dividers of either damped capacitors or resistor type as an oscilloscope with the recording arrangement are provided for measurement of the voltage across the test object. The same voltage dividers of either damped capacitors or it may be resistor type and an oscilloscope for oscilloscope with recording arrangement are provided for what measurement of the voltages across the test object. Sometimes a sphere gap is also provided for calibration purpose. Gas insulated impulse generation. Impulse generation rated for 4 megavolt or above will be very tall and require large space. As such, they are usually located in open space and are housed in an insulated enclosure. The height of the 4.8 megavolt unit may be around 30 meters. The height of that is around 30 meter. To make the unit compact, a compressed gas such as N2 SF6 may be used as a insulation. Impulse generations are needed to generate very fast transient I time duration of 0.5. This is a front and tail time. Okay, this one also same 0.5/5, and this one 0.1/1 microseconds. Waves for testing gas insulated system that are coming up nowadays. The energy needed for testing of this type of equipment is small, less than 30 kV, and the load capacitance is usually less than 500 picofarad. Triggering of impulse generator by three electrode gap arrangement. In this is the diagram for that triggering of impulse generator by three electrode gap arrangement. In large impulse generator, the spark gaps are generally spear gaps or gaps formed by hemispherical electrodes. You have read in breakdown strength, and to find out the breakdown strength of a transformer I, how the spear gaps will be, you have seen in the experiment spear gap. Okay, a gaps formed by a hemispherical electrodes. The gaps are arranged such that sparking of one gap results in automatic sparking of other gap. What happens here? The gap arranged. Okay, a small, you can see here, like this, it will be spark gap. Okay, spark gap between, this is the spark gap. The gap are arranged such that sparking of one gap results in, if sparking one gap results in automatic sparking of other gaps as over voltage is impressed on the other. In order to have consistency in sparking, irradiations from an ultraviolet lamp is provided from the bottom to all the gaps. A simple method of tripping consisting of making the first gap of a three electrode gap and firing it from a controlled source. Okay, a simple method of tripping consists of making the first gap a three electrode gap and firing it, okay, from what controlled source. A figure gives the schematic arrangement for three electrode gap. DC supply, charging unit. This is an impulse generator circuit, to sweep circuit, 500 voltage supply, 0 to 3 kV electrostatic voltmeter. This is 230 voltage, 50 hertz. This is a next. The first stage of the impulse generator is fitted with our 3 electrode gap, and the control electrode is maintained at a potential in between the top and the bottom electrodes with the resistance R1 and R2. Okay. Between that of the top and the bottom electrodes with the resistors R1 and R2. The tripping is insulated by applying a pulse to the thyristor. This is a thyristor G. Okay, this is a G. By closing the switch S, the capacitor C producing exponentially decaying pulse of positive polarity, the pulse goes and initiate the oscilloscope time base. That thyristor conducts on receiving the pulse from the switch. Okay, what it will do? It will receive the pulse. It will receive the what they are saying. The capacitor C produces exponentially decaying pulse of positive polarity. It will produce a positive polarity. The pulse goes on and initiates the oscilloscope time base. The thyroton conducts on receiving. It will conduct on receiving the pulse from the switch. Okay, it will conduct by receiving the pulse from the switch and produces a negative pulse through the capacitor C1 at a central electrode of 3-electrode gap. First, what it will do? The capacitor will produce positive polarity. It will next that pulse what positive polarity. The pulse goes and initiate the oscilloscope time base. And thyroton, what it will do? It will conduct and it will receive the pulse from the switch and produce the negative pulse. It will pass through the capacitance C1 at central electrode of the 3-electrode gap. Hence, the voltage between the central electrode and the top electrode. Okay, the voltage between the central electrode and top electrode of the 3-electrode gaps goes above its parking potential and thus gap conducts. Okay, that's why gap conducts and parking potential will increase. For example, parking potential is 20, means it will increase. Okay, it is above the parking potential and thus gap will conduct. Okay, gap conducts. The time lag required for the thyroton firing and breakdown of the 3-electrode gap ensures that sweep circuit of the oscilloscope begins before the start of the impulse generator voltage. They are saying that time lag is required for the thyroton firing. Okay, it is time lag we require for thyroton firing and breakdown of the 3-electrode gap ensures that they are saying sweep circuit we require. Okay, sweep circuit of the oscilloscope will begin before the start of the impulse generator voltage. It sweep circuit of the oscilloscope, it will begin before the start of the impulse generator voltage. The resistance R2 ensures that decoupling of voltage oscillations produced at the spark gap entering the oscilloscope through the common trip circuit. Okay, through the common trip circuit. The 3-electrode gap requires a large space and elaborate construction. This is the thyroton gap and oscillograph, the time sweep circuits. Okay, this is the insulating building, trigger electrode. This is a trigger electrode. This one is a insulating bushing. Next, earth electrode. Okay, annular gap, high voltage main electrode. Okay, this is the figure shows the thyroton gap. This requires much small voltage for operation. This requires much small voltage it requires for operation compared to what 3-electrode gap. Okay, a thyroton gap consists of high voltage spherical electrode. It has a high voltage spherical electrode of suitable size and an earthed main electrode of spherical shape and a trigger electrode through the main electrode. The trigger electrode is a metal rod with an annular clearance of about 1 mm fitted into the main electrode. It is fitted into the main electrode through a bushing. The triangle thyroton is connected to a pulse circuit. This is a tripping circuit using a thyroton. Tripping of the impulse generator is affected by a trip pulse which produces a spark between the trigger electrode and cathode sphere. A spark will be produced between where trigger electrode and cathode sphere. Tripping of impulse generator, it will affect by trip pulse which produce a spark gap between the trigger electrode and the sphere. Due to space charge effects, due to this, what happens? Distortion of the field in the main gap and spark over of the main gap, it will occur. Okay, due to this effect, what happens? Distortion of the field in the main gap and spark over of the main gap occurs. The trigger gap is polarity sensitive, and a proper polarity pulse should be applied for correct operation. What they are saying, the trigger gap is a polarity sensitive, a proper polarity should be applied for correct operation. Generation of switching surges, switching impulse voltage. This is a circuit for that. This generation of switching surges, I will explain in the next class. Okay. Thank you.